All right, so let's consider this other question. Question says, water at a density of 836 kilograms per meter cube and viscosity of 10 to the power of minus 6 meters squared per second flows through a smooth pipe and a velocity of 2 meters per second. If the diameter is 38 millimeter, calculate the pressure gradient per unit length necessary. Also find the head loss and the power required. Okay, so let's select our parameters. Water at a density, so we have density of the water. Density rho was given to us as 836 kilograms per meter cube, and viscosity. So take note now, when viscosity is expressed in meters squared per seconds, it is simply called kinematic viscosity and not dynamic viscosity. All right, so the kinematic viscosity was given to us. Kinematic viscosity was given to us, that is known, that's the symbol, was given to us as 10 to the power of minus 6 meters squared per second. That's the unit of kinematic viscosity and not dynamic. Dynamic is Newton seconds per meter squared. Also have it in mind, if the viscosity is given to you in poise, it means it's also dynamic viscosity, but you need to convert it from poise to Newton seconds per meter squared. But if it is given to you in Stokes, it is also what? Kinematic viscosity, but you need to convert it to meter squared per seconds. Also take note of that. All right, so let's continue picking our parameters. Now, flows through a smooth pipe as a velocity of 2 meters per second. So velocity is given as V is 2 meters per seconds. If the diameter of the pipe is 38 millimeter, we're given diameter. Okay, all right, let me take it down here. Diameter D was given as 38 millimeter. So we convert this to meter simply by dividing 38 by 1000, and that will give us about 0.038 in meters. All right, so that becomes the diameter. Now, the first question says we should find the pressure gradient. Pressure gradient necessary. That's dP all over dx unknown. So we simply make use of the Hagen-Poisuilles equation. Okay, to find this, we use the Hagen-Poisuilles equation. All right, and the Hagen-Poisuilles equation simply states that dP all over dx, that's the pressure gradient from the Hagen-Poisuilles equation, is equal to 8 times the coefficient of dynamic viscosity times discharge all over pi r to the power of 4. So this is the Hagen-Poisuilles equation. Now, we have to use dynamic viscosity, but we're given kinematic viscosity. So all we need to do is to what? Convert kinematic viscosity down to dynamic viscosity. Now, there's a relationship between dynamic viscosity and kinematic viscosity. Now, what is that relationship? Kinematic viscosity, which is nu, is given as dynamic viscosity all over density. That's their formula. So from here, you can actually find dynamic viscosity to be what? Kinematic viscosity multiplied by density. So the density was given to us in the question as 836 kilograms per meter cube. This simply implies that dynamic viscosity mu becomes density 836 multiplied by kinematic viscosity. And kinematic viscosity was given as 10 to the power of minus 6. So multiplies 10 to the power of minus 6. So this simply implies that the dynamic viscosity mu is now going to be 8.36 by 10 to the power of minus 4. So that gives us the dynamic viscosity. Now, having obtained this, next thing to is to find a discharge, because we are given diameter, so we can easily find radius. So we need to find discharge. All right, so discharge Q, already we know it to be area times velocity, and this is now equal to area itself is pi d squared all over 4 multiplied by velocity. Velocity was given to us in the equation as 2 meters per second. Okay, speed of flow is 2 meters per second. All right, so this simply implies that discharge Q is now equal to pi remains 3.142 multiplied by diameter squared, and diameter was given to us in the equation as 0.038 meters. So we have 0.038 all squared all over 4 multiplied by the speed, which is velocity, and velocity is given as 2 meters per second multiplied by 2. All right, so I will compute the numerator now. Okay, so everything on the numerator, including multiplying by 2, gave us 9.075 multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 3 multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 3 all over 4. So if we do this, we are going to obtain our discharge Q to be equal to divide by 4. That gives us 2.27 by 10 to the power of minus 3. So we have 2.27 by 10 to the power of minus 3 a meter cube per second. So this is now our discharge. So if we know our discharge, we know our dynamic viscosity, we can now plug into this equation to find pressure gradient. Therefore, the P all over the X is now equal to 8 multiplied dynamic viscosity, and dynamic viscosity gave us here as 8.36 by 10 to the power of minus 4. So we have 8.36 by 10 to the power of minus 4. Okay, multiply by discharge. Discharge itself gave us 2.27 by 10 to the power of minus 3 all over. We have here pi r4. Pi remains 3.142. Now the diameter was given as 0.038. So we can find radius from here. Radius becomes our diameter all over 2. Alright, so radius is now equal to divide this by 2. That will give us a radius, 0.038 divided by 2. That gives us 0.019 in meter. So this becomes a radius. So we substitute that value into this equation, 0.019 all to the power of 4. Not forgetting r to the power of 4. Alright, so let me get everything on the numerator. The P all over the X, which is the pressure gradient, is now equal to 8 multiplies 8.36 exponential minus 4 multiplies 2.27 exponential minus 3. That gives us 1.518 by 10 to the power of minus 5 by 10 to the power of minus 5. So the whole of this divides by, let's also obtain the denominator. Denominator is this, 0.019 to the power of 4 times 3.142 . That gives us 4.0947. We have 4.0947 by 10 to the power of minus 7. So let's divide these two together. Okay, 1.5182 exponential minus 5 divided by answer. That gives us 38.08 Pascal. So this becomes the value of the pressure gradient, 38.08 Pascal. That becomes the value of the pressure gradient. All right, the next question says calculate the find the head loss. So to find the head loss, we employ the Daicy-Weisbach equation. Okay, second question, head loss. So we use Daicy-Weisbach equation. Alright, and from Daicy-Weisbach, the head loss due to friction is given as 4FLV squared all over D times 2G, where F stands for the friction factor, and the friction factor depends on the Reynolds number, so which means we need to find the Reynolds number. Now, we already know that Reynolds number RE is equal to rho V D all over mu. So this is now equal to, it is also equal to Vd all over kinematic viscosity. So you can use any of these equations, and I'm 100% sure you will obtain the same result for the Reynolds number. Okay, but okay, let me use the second part since it's quite shorter. All right, so Reynolds number is equal to, so we said V, velocity of flow, was given in the equation at 2 meters per second. So you have 2 multiplied by diameter was given as 0.038 in meters all over. Kinematic viscosity was given as 10 to the power of minus 6. So this implies that Reynolds number is equal to, so you have 76,000, and this is quite greater. It is greater than 4,000. So when the Reynolds number is greater than 4,000, when RU is greater than 4,000, you use friction factor, the equation, you use the equation friction factor F is equal to 0.0791 all over Reynolds number to the power of 1 all over 4. So whenever the Reynolds number is greater than 4,000, you use this equation to find the friction factor. So in the previous video I did, we saw a situation where the Reynolds number was less than 4,000, was even less than 2,000. So there's a different equation for that one as well. But if it is greater than or equal to 4,000, then we'll use this equation to find the friction factor. So this is equal to 0.0791 all over Reynolds number is 76,000 to the power of 1 all over 4. So you have a 0.0791 all over. So let's compute the fourth root of 76,000. So that gives us 16.6036. So the fourth root of 76,000 to the power of 1 over 4 gave us 16.6036. Therefore, 0.0791 divided by that answer, 791 divided by answer, that gives us 4.76. Hence, friction factor F is 4.76 by 10 to the power of minus 3. Okay, by 10 to the power of minus 3. So this gives us the friction factor. Now, if we know the friction factor from the Daicy-Weisbach equation, the length is, take note from the question says calculate the pressure gradient per unit length. So always, like I said, if you're making use of the Hagen-Poisuilles equation, unless otherwise stated, whenever they say pressure gradient per meter length, it simply means that the length is equal to 1. But in this case, now it was specified clearly per unit length. Unit length simply means length is equal to 1. So the length is 1. Velocity was given. We know the diameter. Of course, we cannot compute the head loss. Therefore, head loss due to friction, HF, is now equal to, from the equation, it says 4 multiplied by, okay, 4 times F. F is the friction factor, and this is our friction factor. So 4 times 4.76 multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 3. Multiply by L, unit length, so L is 1, multiply by V squared, and V is 2 meters per second from the question. So we have 2 all squared all over, we have D become diameter of the pipe, and diameter of the pipe was 0.038, multiply by 2, multiply by gravity remains a constant, remember, multiply by 2G, G is a gravity, so it's a constant, 9.8. One. Okay, so let me compute the numerator. Numerator gives us 0.07616 all over. So the whole of the numerator gives us this. So let's compute the denominator. Okay, 0.038 multiplied by 2 multiplies 9.81. Denominator gave us 0.74556. So if we divide through now, we are going to have head loss due to friction to be equal to 0.07616 divided by that answer. That gives us 0.102 in meters. So head loss due to friction is 0.102 in meters. So that becomes the answer to the second question. All right. And the final question says calculate also the power required. Okay, so final question C, power required. Power is simply given as specific gravity, or specific weight, sorry, multiplied by discharge multiplied by head loss due to friction. That's how to calculate the power. So have we solved for discharge? I think we've solved for discharge. Yes, we have actually solved for discharge. Yes, okay, we've solved for discharge earlier, and we obtained discharge to be 2.27 by 10 to the power of minus 3. We'll solve for discharge and we'll obtain this. So let's just plug in everything into the formula. Okay, we have everything all set. Now, specific weight, mind you, specific weight is simply density times gravity. That's what specific weight is, density times gravity. So this implies that power is actually, in place of specific weight, we have density times gravity times discharge times head loss due to friction. So power is equal to density. In the question, density was given as 836 times gravity is 9.81, a constant, times, okay, discharge. We solved for discharge earlier and we obtained 2.27 by 10 to the power of minus 3. So in place of discharge, you have 2.27 by 10 to the power of minus 3. Okay, multiply by next is the head loss due to friction, which will obtain as 0.102. Hence, power required is now equal to, let's multiply all through. Power gives us 1.899 in watts. All right, so this becomes the power required. That becomes the power required, and that is it for that particular question. All right, guys, I hope this video helps you in preparation for your test. If any other thing comes up, I will do well to as well solve and post for you guys. Combine this with all I've done in my YouTube videos on fluid mechanics, and I'm sure you're going to excel in your test. Thanks and cheers.